When making videos for Super Nintendo oscilloscope visualizations, people seem to be confused on what label to write to refer to the Super Nintendo's sound chip. See, this hasn't been a problem with other game consoles. When we open an NES case, we see that the 6502 derivative CPU, labeled the 2A03, controls the unnamed programmable sound generator, which is actually inside the same package as the CPU. That's why we can easily point to the 2A03 as the sound chip, and also the CPU. When we open a Sega Genesis case, we see the Motorola 68000 CPU, which sends the music driver and song data to the 8 KB RAM, which is then read by the Zilog Z80 CPU, which in turn controls the YM2612 FM synthesizer and the SN76489 clone, which is embedded inside the Sega VDP, Video Display Processor, chip, funny enough. Or at least that's how it works most of the time, since the 68000 CPU can also control both sound generators directly, although most programmers prefer to just leave the music to the Z80, since the 68000 is already busy with game logic. That's why we can easily point to the YM2612 and the SN76489 as the Sega Genesis or Mega Drive sound chips. But with the Super Nintendo, it's a slightly different case. It seems that many people are confused. Many people call the sound chip as SPC-700, which is not surprising because we often see Super Nintendo music files with the SPC file extension. But this is not actually correct. When the Super Nintendo starts up, its 5822 CPU, a 65C816 derivative, would read the ROM data from the cartridge and execute it. During the game's loading process, the CPU loads into the 64 KB audio RAM, a sound driver program, which I will explain in a bit. Playing music is done by loading the actual song data, the samples, notes, and music sequence into audio RAM, and then sending a message to the s-smp audio CPU, which understands SPC-700 program code. The s-smp then executes the driver program from the audio RAM, which is responsible for reading the song data and controlling the s-dsp chip, which allows the s-dsp to play the right notes at the right time. This s-dsp chip is the one that actually generates audio. This setup is similar to how the Sega Genesis audio system works. Fun fact, compared to the other chips, the SDSP actually outputs digital audio, which needs to be converted to analog first before getting out of the console. With that in mind, why do many people call the synthesizer of the Super Nintendo the SPC-700? The SPC-700 is a CPU inside the s-smp, which is actually a derivative of the original 2A03 CPU inside the NES. It operates completely separately from the Super Nintendo's main CPU, focused on controlling the s-dsp to play music. The SPC music files we have are actually a dump of the 64 KB audio RAM, which contains the driver program and the music data. The driver program is a program for the SPC-700, which would explain the SPC file extension. That also explains why all SPC files are 64 kilobytes in size. That's because they are RAM dumps of the 64 KB audio RAM. However, as explained earlier, neither the SSMP chip nor the SPC-700 CPU inside is responsible for generating the actual sound. That would be the SDSP. The SPC-700 only sends commands to the SDSP with the right timing to play which note with which sample at what volume. If we were to rip out the SDSP, we could theoretically attach it to any other CPU and control it to play music. Imagine putting it inside the Sega Genesis. Ridiculous, but it could probably work with enough time and effort. Both the SDSP and SSMP were developed by Sony, which would give the Super Nintendo its unbelievably advanced audio capabilities that other consoles at the time could only dream of. It has tons of advanced features that I won't go into, but I'm sure you will find them in other YouTube videos. Sony would go on to improve this technology they developed and then use it again when creating the PlayStation. I hope this video has been informative.